see here. I'm not sure how to do this tonight. Improvising. I just had a wedding at 3 o'clock in Fargo at the cathedral. And then, let me see here what I got in the background here. And then I had a wedding rehearsal that I just finished just now. And so, there's a lot of noise around here with cars and stuff, but I'm gonna pull up a rock or something here. This is our shrine outside of the Church of St. Philip's in Hankinson. And I just came out here to look and see what I could do as far as finding a spot to sit down. There's no spot, hang on. And this is Our Lady of Fatima. And this is a shrine at St. Philip's Church in Hankinson. And I don't know if you see all the kids there. Maybe you can't see all of them, but there's the three children. And Jacinta, Lucia, and Francesco. And of course, apparitions were in 1913, was it? 17. And it was right after the war, or toward the end of the war, World War I. And now I'm just getting me on here to make sure that I actually am live. On here. Move these all over. Don't need that. Phillips. New activity. There we are. Oh, what a pretty picture. Can you see? There's one of the kids. I think there's one of the kids in there. So, I did back up. Now I'm just turning up my volume. There we go. I just want to make sure you can hear me. This is all sort of impromptu here tonight, because like I say, I just had a wedding in Fargo at 3, and then I had a wedding rehearsal here at 6 o'clock tonight here at St. Philip's, and here we are. I just got out here. What a great day, and that's with qualifications, of course. It started out to be what an awful morning Fargo and Points North had. My goodness, I was watching that on the news, and flooding and house fire and power outages, and oh my, it's scary this morning. So anyway, I pray that you're all safe after that. I just got in a little bit, but I drove into Fargo about 1:32 o'clock, and so it rained some, but it wasn't anything like you had earlier. So for all the people that experienced, actually just north of here too, Wahpeton, all the points along the way from Wahpeton north, you all had quite the rains and storms. Even Lisbon, the west of us had it, but it just skirted north of Wahpeton, or north of Hankinson. As far as I can tell, we had rain maybe early this morning, but there's no... The streets aren't wet, the sidewalks aren't wet. This here is all dry. So we just missed it. Thanks be to God. What else? You're going into the group. This is Friday night now, so we haven't left for the lakes yet. You will be soon, probably, or tomorrow morning. So I pray, like I said yesterday, a safe time and a smart time. Be North Dakota smart when you're in Minnesota or North Dakota lakes. Just be really smart. You saw the terrible drowning last week. It was of a man in Detroit Lakes, Minnesota. so sad. And so always be ready, be aware of most drownings are accidents. They just, that's what they are. They're mistakes, and mistakes that turn deadly. Like, if you don't swim and you're out in the water, wear a life vest. You won't have time to put one on if you fall in the water, especially if you're alone. So wear the life vest. If you're diving into water, don't until you know what's under that water. You know, the neck doesn't have a lot of leeway to it. That water is shallow, or there's a rock there, and you don't know it's there. When you dive right into that, you might be in a wheelchair or in a bed the rest of your life. So all those things, just stop for a second and be smart. Recon the area you're in. Know what you need in case something goes bad. If something goes bad, you will not have time to go back and readjust. Being a little grim here, but I want to make sure that you stay safe, because we need you. We need you on Earth. Well, whenever the Lord calls you, of course, he can do that. But we do like your prayers and your company and everything here on Earth. So please be safe. Now, we're here at the Shrine of Our Lady of Fatima. As I said, there's a little history about that, obviously. Mary appeared to the three children I could be wrong. Let's go with Fatima for now. Either one. It's with the Lourdes of Fatima. Now that I'm looking, I think, oh, this might be Lourdes. But I've been to both places, and I was in Fatima. Fatima is where on October 13th, 1917, the last apparition, they had the miracle of the sun, where the people came to it, lots of people were there, they even had pictures in the paper, and it was pouring rain, and people had all their umbrellas out, and all standing in the mud, and then the miracle of the sun began, the sun began spinning and moving toward the earth, people went on their knees, they thought there was the end of the world, started screaming and praying the rosary, and it happened three times. And then when the sun finally retreated to its normal place, the sky was clear and everybody was dry, including the ground, in that short period of time. They call it the miracle of the sun. Now, we often feel like we want to go places and visit shrines and so on, pilgrimages. That's wonderful, and it does enhance our faith. But we have to remember they enhance our faith. They don't make or break our faith. That's the important thing. So like when I was in Fatima, at the shrine, we were leaving for Paris early in the morning. So I got up about, I think 3:30 and 4:30. I wanted to go down and pray at the shrine one more time. So I get down there, and it's an open area. And I go in there, and the statue of Our Lady of Fatima is gone. And, oh my gosh, I got up all early, and oh, the statue isn't even here. Oh Lord, what do I do? All of a sudden, this woman's voice inside me said, "Did you come to pray to me or a statue?" I thought, "Oh, thank you, Mary. Good point. I came to pray to you." So it was. I've never forgot that experience. That woman's voice saying, "Did you come to pray to me or to a statue?" And we need to remember that, because sometimes we get wrapped up in things like this. You know, where. There's something magic about it. There's nothing magic about it at all. In fact, that's wrong. They're just reminders to us of our faith life, our walk in the Lord, and they encourage our faith, but they don't replace it, and they don't do magic. So remember that. It's beautiful to look at, beautiful to enhance our faith, but don't make it the beginning and end of our faith. You know, it's just not, and it will never be. So with that, let's go to our night prayer. Hi there. We're face to face here, aren't we? Which one are you, Lucia? Or... Okay, let me find the night prayer here. This is the night prayer tonight is actually, we're in the vigil of the Assumption of Mary, which is not celebrated as an obligation this weekend, so you're not obliged. but it is celebrated in the Liturgy of the Hours, and tonight in night prayer, it's the night prayer for Sunday evening prayer one, since it's the Solemnity of Mary of the Assumption. O God, come to my assistance. Lord, make haste to help me. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Have mercy on us, O Lord, for we have sinned against you. Show us, O Lord, your mercy, and grant us your salvation. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Now that the daylight dies away, by all thy grace and love, thee, maker of the world, we pray, to watch our bed above. Let dreams depart and phantoms fly, the offspring of the night. Keep us like shrines beneath thine eye, pure in our foes despite. This grace on thy redeemed confer, Father, co-equal Son, and Holy Ghost, the Comforter, eternal three in one. Psalm prayer 4, a prayer of thanksgiving. When I call, answer me, O God of justice. From anguish you release me. Have mercy and hear me. O men, how long will your hearts be closed? Will you love what is futile and seek what is false? It is the Lord who grants favors to those whom he loves. The Lord hears me whenever I call him. Fear him, do not sin. Ponder on your bed and be still. Make justice your sacrifice and trust in the Lord. What can bring us happiness, many say? Let the light of your face shine on us, O Lord. You have put into my heart a greater joy than they have from abundance of corn and new wine. I will lie down in peace, and sleep comes at once. For you alone, Lord, make me dwell in safety. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Have mercy, Lord, and hear my prayer. In the silent hours of night, bless the Lord. O come, bless the Lord, all you who serve the Lord, who stand in the house of the Lord, in the courts of the house of our God. Lift up your hands to the holy place and bless the Lord through the night. May the Lord bless you from Zion, he who made both heaven and earth. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. In the silent hours of night, bless the Lord. A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord, and you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your might. And these words which I command you this day shall be upon your heart, and you shall teach them diligently to your children, and shall talk of them when you sit in your house, and when you walk by the way, and when you lie down, and when you rise. Said today is the solemnity of the Feast of the Assumption of Mary, Mother of God, and well, we won't go into the whole theology of Mary, but it's something that when you really study it, makes a lot of sense. First of all, the Immaculate Conception and the Assumption, the Immaculate Conception. Mary, most all religions agree, is the Mother of God. She gave birth to the Savior. That's not a debate. The debate is she immaculate? Was she a virgin? Is she without sin? Well, look at it this way. Where God is, sin cannot exist. Not even the stain of sin. Not even the stain, the slightest stain. God cannot exist there because first, he will wipe it out because it's even the stain of sin, and it'll cease to exist. So the angel Gabriel says that the Holy Spirit is going to come upon Mary, and she's now becoming the spouse of the Holy Spirit, and through the Holy Spirit she will conceive in her womb. Who will she conceive? The angel says to her, and behold, our Savior, Messiah, Jesus, who will save us from our sins. The Son of God, second person of the Trinity, is now being conceived in the womb of Mary, God dwells in her in the fullness of the Trinity. There cannot even be a stain, not even a smudge of sin in Mary. Otherwise, she would have gone on. She could not contain the Son of God in her womb if she had any possibility of sin in her at all. So how do you fix that? Because everybody's born with original sin. In the document of the Vatican of the Church on the Immaculate Conception of Mary, it's titled The Most Magnificent God. And what it is that Mary, Jesus Christ came to redeem the world, and the first person he redeemed was his mother. And when she was conceived, and her parents were, she redeemed her, so she was born, conceived without original sin, no sin whatsoever, and full of grace. Mary was the first to be saved by her Son, the Redeemer, even before he took on flesh in her womb. God can work beyond time and space. He doesn't need to wait till he's born to save somebody. No, he can save her. He had to get her ready. She had to be pure and immaculate so he could be conceived in her womb. And then, okay, she gave birth, so is she a virgin or not? Well, we say Blessed Virgin Mary. So, okay, how did that happen? She is the spouse of the Holy Spirit. When the angel Gabriel said to Mary, "Behold, you will conceive a son, and you will name him Jesus, for he will be of the line of David," the house of Joseph in the line of David. Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I do not know man? I'm a virgin. How can this be?" Now, if Mary thought it had to do with later, when she moved into Joseph's house and they finally were married, Joseph is of the line of David. So it only makes sense if the angel said that, Mary could have said, "Of course I am. Of course it will be. I'm moving in with Joseph. He's of the line of David. Baby to be born, we'll call him Jesus. He's a good deal." But Mary didn't say that to the angel. Mary said, "How can this be?" In other words, Mary knew that what the angel was saying was going to happen immediately. Now, power of the Holy Spirit. So Mary, in conceiving the Word of God in her womb through the power of the Spirit, became forever the spouse of the Holy Spirit. Wow. What a powerful person to intercede for us is Mary now. All of her interceding for us before the Lord, being Son of the Redeemer, before Him, is through the power of the Holy Spirit, since she is intimately united with the Spirit as the spouse of the Holy Spirit. Anyway, there's lots to go on with Mary, but I better stop there. So, let's go on. And the assumption we'll get to, but not today. Into your hands, Lord, I commend my spirit. Into your hands, Lord, I commend my spirit. You have redeemed us, Lord God of truth. Into your hands, Lord, I commend my spirit. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Into your hands, Lord, I commend my spirit. Protect us, Lord, as we stay awake. Watch over us as we sleep, that awake we may keep watch with Christ, and asleep rest in his peace. Lord, now you let your servant go in peace. Your word has been fulfilled. My own eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared in the sight of every people. A light to reveal you to the nations and the glory of your people Israel. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Protect us, Lord, as we stay awake. Watch over us as we sleep, that awake we may keep watch with Christ, and asleep rest in his peace. Let us pray. Lord, we beg you to visit this house and banish from it all the deadly power of the enemy. May your holy angels dwell here to keep us in peace. And may your blessing be upon us always. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. May the all-powerful Lord grant us a restful night and a perfect end. Amen. Now for tonight, we'll have the hymn, Mary the Dawn, which I think is, you'll be able to see the shrine here as this hymn is being sung. Such a beautiful hymn. It's a litany almost of Mary.
Christ the perfect day, Mary the gate, Christ the heavenly way. Mary.
stop there. Oops, ordinary. You'll have a great night, and we'll see you tomorrow night at 7 p.m. Central Daylight Time. And by then, I'll have joined another couple in the sacrament of matrimony. The Lord be with you. The Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go and announce the gospel of the Lord. Thanks be to God. See you tomorrow night.